In the example we were just talking about with the Marvel comic book characters, the strength of the link between some character I and some character J was the number of comic books they appeared in together. Now, this isn't actually a very useful metric for real-life social networks. I have not appeared in any comic books with anyone. I have one friend who actually has appeared in a comic book. A researcher by the name of Michael Bowling at the University of Alberta actually had a comic book character made about himself, which is pretty awesome. But I didn't appear in that comic book with him. So that's not a very good metric. You know, we wouldn't really need to be studying weighted social networks just for comic book characters, but there's lots of other natural measures of the strength of a connection between a person I and a person J. You could imagine saying they're more strongly connected as a function of how often they email each other, or maybe how many years they've known each other, the frequency with which they meet in a given week, how often they rate each other's posts on some kind of social networking site, maybe the number of news articles both have read, and you can imagine lots more examples like these. So this notion of having a weight in a social network is actually a pretty important and relevant concept. So we had talked about shortest paths in a graph, but now let's extend this notion to the shortest weighted path in a graph. So here, in this example now, we're going to look at a high weight, meaning a weak connection, and a low weight, meaning a strong connection. So you can think of the weights almost as being a kind of cost. And we're looking for basically cheap routes from one person in the network to another. So an example of this sort of thing might be that we want to send a message from one person to another in a social network, minimizing, say, social awkwardness. For example, my son is really interested in American history, and my dean is an expert in American history, and he wanted to ask the dean a question. But that's kind of awkward. They actually don't know each other directly. To the extent that they do know each other directly, it's, you know, random young men don't generally contact deans of big arts, schools of arts and sciences. There's sort of high social awkwardness for that. But I was able to help get a message from my son to the dean because I have very low social awkwardness with my son, and I have fairly low social awkwardness with the dean. So the path of sending a message, basically a recommendation for a book to read about American history, traveled much more easily through me to the dean than it would have to the dean directly. Oh, and I should note that my son also has curly hair.